Previous class we have seen what is idealism, what are its philosophical belief, what are its origin, how it originated, and what are the different aspects of idealism. All those things we have discussed. Now we will see its educational implication, how this idealism is helping the educational process. Okay, so while discussing the idealism, we had already seen that in the idealism, the greater importance to the spiritual value is emphasized rather than the material value, materialistic opinion, materialistic world. That was lesser emphasized and that was not having the prime importance. Rather than the spiritual values, ethics, morality, all those things was emphasized in the idealism. And that's why the idealism talks the spiritual development, not the material attainment. Material attainment is not a part of idealism. Rather than the spiritual development is a part of it, idealism. So spiritualism is emphasized. And here we have also seen that when we talk about the materialism and the material attainment, idealistic philosophy says that they are mortal in nature. When the time will come when they will go. So they are mortal. So we must focus on which is immortal, which will not die, which will not go. And that is the your conduct, your mind, your ideas. So that's why they are emphasizing the spiritualism, not the material attainment. And a very important part in the spiritualism is that they are talking about the mental exercise, mental attainment and the ideas of a mind. And it is also scientifically proved by the research nowadays that the mental exercise can be done and it can be reached to its optimal performance when you have a physically sound. If you have a physically sound body, then you can attain the mental, you can exercise the mental power and you can use your ideas, you can generate the idea, you can bring the innovations and the creativity and the critical thinking. So unless or until you are not physically fit, those things will not come. So the thing that we are talking about, the spiritual attainment, that can come with the physical development. So physical development is also have a very important place in the idealistic philosophy, isn't it? And then they talk about the intellectual development. The education should be for the intellectual development, because intellect is the power through which the idea can come. Intellect is the power through which the mental exercise can be brought, isn't it? So these are the basis of education as per the idealistic philosophy. So these are the basis of the education as per the idealistic philosophy. You can also understand as the aim of education as per the idealism. The aim is to develop spiritually. The spiritual development is a more emphasis given here. The physical development is also emphasized, because unless or until we don't have a sound physique, then we cannot expect a spiritual development. And the spiritual development is not possible without the physical well-being. That's why the physical development is also emphasized. And the ultimate goal of the idealistic philosophy is that through the education, the intellectual development should happen in the child. Because unless or until we don't have an intellect, we cannot exercise our mental process. We cannot bring the idea, innovation and all those things. Isn't it? So these are that the basis of education, the main aim of education as per the idealism. Even the idealistic philosophers, they talk about the development of unity in the diversity and the democratic values. The aim of education as per the idealism is to develop the unity in diversity and the democratic values. And the logic is very beautiful in the idealism. The logic is that in the idealism, spiritual got the prime importance. And they say that the idea is important, not the child. Child is a secondary. The body is secondary. Because this is the mortal. But the idea and the mind is the important. That would must get a primacy over the materials. And if the mind and thought and idea is a prime are with the prime importance, then the every child must have a right of education. Because unless or until we are not educating them, we are not empowering them intellectually, then we cannot get the idea of the child. We cannot nurture. So idea is important. So if the idea is important, then it is a right of every child to get the education, to become intellectually sound, and to nurture their ideas by exercising the power of mind. And that's why they talk about the unity in diversity, because all humans are same. Their mind is same. Mind is capable of generating the thought, bringing the innovations and ideas. And that's why they say that there must be unity despite of lots of diversity that we have. And that's why they are in favor of promoting the democratic values. Because unless or until we don't have a democratic values, the right of education cannot be ensured, and the treatment of all the child equally cannot be ensured. Unity in diversity, how it will come unless or until we will not have a democratic values. That's why the aim of education as per the idealism is to promote unity in diversity and the democratic values. Then the one of the very important thing as per the aim of idealism is that cultivation of a truth, beauty and a goodness. Like that we used to say that the Satyam, Sivam and Sundaram. And that is the very beautifully articulated the three domains of a learning. That is the cognitive, affective and psychomotor. The truth is that the truth, the idea, the exercise of a mind that prevails. So truthness is seen as the intellectual development of the person. Because unless or until we have not grown intellectually, you will be not able to judge what is right. You will be not able to generate the idea. So, if the intellectual power will be developed, then your idea will come, which is the immortal. And as per the idealism, that is the truth. Truth here is seen universally, not locally or in the context. So, when we talk about the ethics, the moral conduct, they used to see this as a universal phenomenon. The beauty is praising the truth. The process of praising the truth is the beauty. So that ability should also be cultivated through the education. Then there comes goodness. Goodness is a skill to exercise the intellectual. Because if you have an intellectual capacity, if you have a capacity to praise the beauty, but you don't have the ability to exercise the truth and the beauty, then it is also not meaningful. So when we talk about the truth, beauty and a God, goodness, that is the Satyam, Sivam and Sundaram, that is the very beautifully linked with the three domains of a learning in the idealism. That is the cognitive, affective and a psychomotor. So this was the aim of education as per the idealism. Then we will see the curriculum as per the idealistic philosophy. When we talk about the curriculum, they used to divide the curriculum into the two parts. The one part is the physics and the another part is the spiritual. Why this physic comes? Because earlier, while discussing the aim of education, we had already seen that without the sound physic, we cannot expect the development of an idea and the spiritualism. And that's why when the point of curriculum comes in the idealism, they also emphasize the physical part. That is the health, well-being, physically, how to become a physically sound, health and the physique. That is also comes in the curriculum of idealistic philosophy. And the second thing which comes in the physique is that the skill part, like that the three things we were discussing, that is the truth, beauty and goodness. So in the goodness we were talking about the skill part. So that goodness come in the physique because it is related to the muscle power, skill. So that is coming to the physique. And that another thing which is related to the mental exercise is coming under the spiritualism. And it talks about the intellectual development, intellects, the moral, aesthetic and religion. Because in the idealism, when we have discussed, they have never denied the existence of a God. And when you will see the different idealistic philosopher, someone you will find that they very clearly talk about the existence of God. And someone, they don't clearly talk about the existence of a God. However, they are in a favor of a spiritualism, moral and ethics. So when we see these four, intellect, moral, aesthetic and religion. So within the intellect, the subjects related to the language and literature, subject related to the social science like a geography, history, politics, it will come, and subject related to the science. Because for the intellectual development and ideas to come and generate, these all things, exposure to these all subjects are very much necessary. And they also talked about the moral. So here the ethics will come under this. They also talk about the aesthetic, and in this aesthetic, the different type of art and music, fine art, performing art, like that, it comes. And obviously the fourth one is when they talk about the religion, the study of religious literature is also comes when we talk about the curriculum in the idealistic philosophy. However, this was the general outlook of the curriculum as per the idealistic philosophy. Different idealistic philosophers have defined the curriculum in a different way. One of the very prominent philosopher in the school of idealistic philosophy is the Plato. And he was in opinion that aim of life is to realize the God. I have just talked that sometimes they are not very clear about the existence of a God or not existence of a God, but none of them have denied the existence of God. Plato was one who was talking that the aim of a life is a realization of a God, and that is the ultimate truth. So that is the point of spiritualism as per the Plato, and says that since the ultimate aim of life is to realize the God, which is possible by truth, beauty and goodness. That is the intellectual development, aesthetic development and a moral development and the skill development. So that is the prime focus of the idealistic philosophy as per the Plato is concerned. And this is known as the Plato scheme of a curriculum in the idealistic philosophy. There was another very prominent philosopher in the idealism, Herbert Spencer. And he was in opinion that idealistic aim of education is promotion of moral values. Aesthetic is not important here. Skill is not important as per the Herbert Spencer scheme in the idealistic philosophy. So he was saying that the aim of education is promotion of moral values. And that's why the literature, art and music, history, politics, these should get a prime importance rather than the science. So in his scheme, science is a secondary, whereas the language, literature, music and all those things are primary in nature. Then the third thing is another philosopher, that is the T.P. Nuns. So in the opinion of a T.P. Nuns, he says that a school should promote and maintain morality and the historical traditions to preserve and keep its achievement. So he was in opinion that education as per the idealism must be promoting and maintaining morality. Promote and maintain. And the second thing is that historical traditions to preserve and keep its achievement. That is the historical traditions, the historical achievement that we have in our the human life, that must be preserved, that must be outlined, that must be transferred to the next generation. And that's why when we talk about the curriculum as per the T.P. Nun, you will find the art, music, history, literature, language, all the things will get an important place. And here also you will find science as a secondary place in the curriculum. Rudy already know that idealism has emerged out of the theory that is known as a theory of ideas of a Plato. It has emerged from there, and that's why it is known that Plato is the person who have introduced idealism in the education. And that's why when we see the Plato, he state that the man and his mind is a great importance, because human personality is more worthy than the material world. Because when we talk about the curriculum, we must understand what is the view on curriculum as per the prominent philosopher who have introduced this idealism in the field of education. So Plato was in opinion that the mind must get the prime importance rather than the material world. That's why when we have discussed the Plato opinion on the curriculum, you will find that the way of realization of a God, like that the beauty, truth and goodness is emphasized in the Plato curriculum. Even when you will see some other philosophers, like Pestalozzi, like Froebel, they also says that education to be a process which leads one to the highest moral conduct and to develop the spiritual insight, that is the truth, goodness and beauty. So you will find that majority of Western philosophers in the idealistic school of philosophy, they are agree with the opinion on education of the Plato and the scheme of curriculum as per the Plato. They are agree with that. Even when we talk about the Swami Vivekananda, he says that the development of the spiritual value is more important, and the spiritual values are within the mind of the child. It is not related like that you have to develop and have to imbibe the spirituality from outside. It is within the mind of a child, and that needs to be developed. So that was the opinion of even the Vivekananda about the idealism in the education. Now we will see about the different type of methods of teaching as per the idealistic philosophy. What are the method they proposed? Because when we talk about the aim of education and the curriculum, so curriculum is a modality to transact the aim of education in the education, and the method of teaching is the modality to realize the aim of education. So if you want to realize the aim of education, you must have a method of teaching. So when we talk about the method of a teaching, idealistic philosophers are very open in this sense, and they are have a set of a variety of methods like narration, explanation, questioning, discussion, even for the small child playway method, observation and practice and repetition for development of a skill, because the skill can be developed by the repeated practice. And when you will see the method of a teaching, this includes almost all modern method of a teaching of the constructivist philosophy. In the constructivism also, there is an opportunity of narration where you can narrate the thing. Explanation, you can explain by the examples, explain with the demonstration. Questioning, to know their understanding, their difficulty, to understand the child and to adapt the appropriate method of teaching. So questioning is also there. Observation, so that they can learn how the things work, and after the observation they can have a session of a practice and a repetition. Even for the small child, playway method is also suggested in the idealism. Now we will see the place of a teacher in the idealistic philosophy. When we see the place of a teacher in the idealistic philosophy, the place of a teacher was very high, respectable, and the important one. And they were enjoying the glorious position in the educational process. They believe that the teacher is next to God, and he carries the child from the darkness of ignorance to the light. So teacher is a person who brings the child from the darkness to the light. And in the sort, you can say that the teacher was supposed as a guide to the children. They were guide of the children. They were guiding, and the student were learning from the act of a teacher, and that's why the teacher post was respectable, however with a responsibility to lead the child. And even when we talk about the concept of a student in the idealism, one thing already I have told, that here the body and a child is immaterial. The important is the thought and the idea, and that's why they used to treat every child equally. There is no discrimination among the children. And they believe that idealistic philosophy gives more emphasis to the idea and the thought, where in it provides a secondary place to the child, because the child is not more important. Then idealistic philosophy believe that the child is a limited soul, and he has made the unlimited belief that the child unlimited belief through the appropriate educating process. So through the appropriate educating process, their thought, their ideas can be developed. There is one philosopher in idealism, that B.B. Bogoslowski. He says that the student is a finite person, growing when properly educated in the image of the infinite person. Infinite person, that is the teacher. So child is a finite, their mind is a finite, that can be grown by educating by the infinite man, that is the teacher. So in the teacher's guidance, they can flourish, they can be nurtured. Even when we talk about the discipline as per the idealism, here one thing is very important to discuss, that in the idealism, the teacher is responsible to bring the student from darkness to the light. And the student will get inspired from the teacher. And that's why all the thing that can be done to bring the student from darkness to the light is permissible. And that's why here the punishment and all those things are also permissible to maintain the discipline. because as per the idealism, the moral and the ethics have a prime importance. So in order to maintain the moral and ethics, the punishment and the other strategy can also be implemented.